Welcome to the testing world. In this session, I'll show you how we can work on variables by using bean shell scripting. So for that, first of all, I'm moving to JMeter, and what I want to do here, I'm moving to test plan level. I have few variables, I'm just removing them. So yeah, I'm creating a variable with the name URL and giving the value like www.thetestingword.com. So that's my variable, and I want to use this variable when I want to make a request. So how to use the variable? Curly brace, dollar curly brace, and the variable. Now I'll show you, is it working or not? So I just run it, and you will notice, yes, I'm able to send a request on this URL. Now I want to fetch value of URL by using bean shell. So first of all, I'm going here and adding a preprocessor, and here we are using bean shell preprocessor. Means, so preprocessor are going to execute before sending a request. So before sending a request, I want to fetch URL, or I'll say I want to make URL entry in the logs. How we can do that? For that, I'm coming here, CTX, which is a JMeter context object. I'm saying get variable. That's a method. Get variables, it's going to fetch all the variables. Now I want to get a variable with the name URL. I want to fetch the value of that. So that is going to fetch value of URL variable. I want to make entry in the logs. So I'm doing like log.info, and I'm saying URL of this request semicolon. Clear. Run. So if we check it here, we are getting URL of the request is this. So we are fetching URL value in bean shell scripting. So we have fetch value of the URL. So we can fetch value of URL. In the same way, I'm going to use a JMeter context object to change the value of the URL. So that's important. What I'm doing, change value of URL. So what I'm doing is CTX dot get variables dot put, and which variable you want to work on. So I'm working on a variable with the name URL, and what value you want to set. So I want to set like /testing, or we can go any other URL. So now the point is, I have changed the URL in preprocessor, means before sending a request. So now if the URL value is changed, next time when we are going to execute this, value of the URL variable would be changed. So request will be go to the new URL. Okay, let me show you. I have just clear previous result, executed. Now if there is no error, means yes, it is executed successfully. I'm coming here, failed. Even it is going to the new URL, but we are not getting any data. It's getting failed. So what I do, I just update my URL, which is testings, right? And if you want to see this URL, I just copied it, moving to the browser. That's the application. So if I change my URL, now clear screen, run again. It should go to the new URL. I'm checking here. Yes, this time it's passed. And in response, we are getting this. So if you want to check here, I'm just going to display the HTML format. So now it displayed in the HTML format. So you can check it like that is coming in the HTML, which is register. And here also we are getting register. The point is, we have updated the value of the URL by using JMeter context object. And one thing I want to note is, like, if that variable exists, it will change the value at the runtime. If that does not exist, I have just deleted. Now if that does not exist, and now we execute, it is going to create that variable and use it. So still we are able to work on this because that variable does not exist, so it has created and used. So if you want to create or update variable, we can use this get variables then put. Then we have remove variables. Okay, what I can do now, I'm again creating a variable here on the test plan level, which is URL www.thetestingword.com, and I'm going to the preprocessor and I want to remove value of the URL. So I'm removing like CTX, which is context, JMeter context object. I'm saying removing value of variable. So CTX dot, and I'm going for get variables dot remove. Which variable you want to remove? So I want to remove a variable with the name URL. And what I'm doing, I'm just commenting rest of the lines. Clear screen, run. So now if you notice, we should get error. Why error? Because the URL you are using, it does not exist. Because why? What we have done? Even it exists here on the test plan level, but by preprocessor, we have deleted that. So now we cannot use in our sampler. So we have seen how we can get variable value, how we can create or update variable value, and how we can remove variables. So that's all we have for this session. Here we have seen how we can work on variables using Bean Shell. That's all we have. Thanks for watching this video.